Rest in peace to all the kids that lost their lives in the Parkland shooting. This song is dedicated to you. Yeah. Rest in peace to all the kids that lost their lives in the Parkland shooting. This song is dedicated to you.
Okay, shaky con, never seen a nine. In I don't mind, pushing Q to buy. I'm lost to the god, I'm in my mind. Swear I wanna die, yeah, when you cross my mind. I wanna die, yeah, no, I'm not a riot, yeah. I might start a riot, yeah. I'm so fucking tired, yeah. So what's up, what you say? Feeling good, I'm feeling great. Tired of the fucking hate, stacking cheese all on my plate.
Good morning. I got my morning coffee here. I have everything ready. Tastes amazing. It says I really need a day between Saturday and Sunday. I hope everyone's doing good today. I'm doing fine. I'm finding hope in everyone. Let's get started. You don't drink coffee? Maybe something you might grow into. I grew into it. In the mornings, I used to get up and get ready for a workout. Do a 2-mile run. And it wasn't cutting for me. Like, every morning, I would feel a little bit sluggish because of all the workouts. It would really take its toll on me. And I'm thinking the OJ, you know, the orange juice might help me. But nah, as soon as I drank coffee, I knew from right there, from the jump, that I would be addicted to it. It really, like, breathes fresh air to you. It gives you that extra, like, shower. You take a cold shower, and then you drink coffee, and that really wakes you up. Smell was so terrible, it put me off of coffee. That's a bad mixture, really. I don't know why you would want to smoke cigarettes, and, if anything, maybe you could probably convince her in the future to start vaping, like maybe something like non-tobacco, or maybe a small amount of tobacco. Get her off of that habit and get her onto maybe a slightly better one. I know. My mother, she likes to smoke. She likes to smoke blacks, and I think that's kind of disgusting. So what I did was got her a vape, and she started using that now. I terribly hate smoke. The only thing I like from smoke is from the ganja. That's really it. I don't think tobacco is the best thing for our body. Okay. Hello, everyone. Today, it's 6%. And with 6%, we are chasing after, you know, we're chasing after the 7%. If you don't know what I'm talking about, it's obviously referring to my de-rust process, getting back into the game, I guess. My dad chews tobacco, which is just as bad, if not worse. If not worse, dang. Dang. That's crazy. I've seen chewing tobacco. Like, they have, like, cans of it. Especially around my gas station. They got a couple of them. And hey, hey, Emmy. Hey, Dark Fantasy, what's up? How you doing? You're speaking on from YouTube chat. I can see you guys as well. If you guys didn't know, I can see both Twitch and YouTube. Fairly new thing for me. Hope your morning is great. Mine is great. Hopefully you're doing better though. When I started off in high school, most of the private schools, like, it was weird. They have chewing tobacco there. A lot of them, they chew dip. And they almost tried to get me to chew dip one time. They almost did. It was like, yo, Dirk, you want some pack? You want some dip? Started shaking it right in front of my face. I was like, what is that? He's like, bro, it's good. You should try some. I was so close to putting it on my fucking tongue. And they were so close to cracking up because chewing tobacco is probably the most disgusting thing I could ever smell and or taste in my life. I cannot ever find myself doing it again, but it takes a real man to really love chewing tobacco, I guess. But I'll stick to the to some bubble gum instead, like most people should. Hello from Italy. Hey, how you doing? Dario, how you doing? If I'm saying that right, hopefully I am. It's a big thing around here. It really is, huh? Weed is the real shit. Look, I wouldn't say, because it's not a good thing to preach about, you know, the weed, ganja, but it's going to become legal soon. And I believe very soon. So, that's my prediction out there. Getting high right now. See, the fact that your name is BongToker420XXX proves to me that you're definitely not a rookie. You definitely understand it. You understand. I think I get it from there. Hey, thank you, man. Appreciate it. I love you. I just want to spread some positivity out there for you guys in this morning. I want to spit a little prayer for you guys. Hopefully you have a great morning and a great afternoon as well. I hope you find everything in your day pleasing. I hope you find something fortunate to happen in your life today. And hopefully you know that I care for you because you guys made me. And you guys gave me company where I don't deserve it. But, let's see. Weed is a big thing around here, too. Oh, damn. It is? Where are you from? Sounds like I might have to give it a visit. Just like I gave Florida a visit. If anyone out there is from Florida, let me know. I might link up with you if I ever go back out there. Probably one of my better times were out in Florida. The fuck you mean? You deserve company. Oh, that's very appreciative. Everyone deserves company. Other than that, let's see. I did it once, but it made me sick, not from tobacco. But itself, but the nicotine. It's fucking, yo, it's disgusting. Country roads, ooh. Oh, yeah. Now, in the country, you could do anything out in the country. No one's going to say shit. Because no one's around. It's a lot of wide open space. So, that's how they work. Question one. Why do you infuse your weapons? If you have a ring of blades and Flynn's ring, isn't it better without infusion? Correct. It is. But the thing is that when you're SL 150 and you fight players that are unfortunately that are either at a 200 is when you want to uninfuse your weapons. I expect other players to be 150. When you're 150 and another player is 150, the infusion impacts them more because dark damage is stronger against armor, you know, regular stuff. But it's no point. Let me tell you this now. If you're fighting players that are over like 150 to 200 area, I would recommend if you have high scaling in the weapon, I would go with uninfused. And if they have great magic barrier or anything like that, uninfused, of course. But when I use a dark infused weapon, I'm expecting 150s to fight me, and that should do more damage than it should. But really what I'm doing is, you know, not helping. It doesn't help at all. I'll be blatantly honest with you. If anyone's overleveled from 150 to 155, if they're higher than that, maybe like, say, 200, don't, you know, infuse your weapons. And that's basically what I would say you should follow. Are you still playing DSR, or did you give up on it like most people? So, Granny. Babe, Granny, no, not PS4 today, I'm sorry. Not PS4 today. I want to do PS4 soon because I feel like they would, for some reason, PS4 would give me a really good fight club. Like Wrecked, you, and a couple of people from the PS4 community will come out and they would probably show out for us. So I'm definitely planning to do a fight club in the near future of that. It'll be really fun. DSR is fucking laughable. Well, from what I've seen out of like the stats, like I was like watching it, the analytics of like how many people were playing the game, and it's like it dropped so much from week 3 to 6. Like there's so much going on. Wow. Like everyone just left. So, I guess they went to their respective communities or left the community all together. I don't know. I'm switching between YouTube and Twitch. There's no point. It's all the same. Maybe Twitch might have a little bit more flock because a lot more people are talking on Twitch. So, you're going to see me talking to people or make it look like it seem like I'm talking to myself. But it's really to the Twitch viewers, and if not, it's really to the YouTube viewers. I would spit on Miyazaki's grave, honestly. Dang, man. You know what? Just think about what Miyazaki's doing right now. Thanks for the advice. I'm playing at 200 or 250, so that's why I asked. Oh, okay. So, yeah, I would focus on your scaling instead. Like, if you're focusing on the weapon, say if it's a dex weapon, scale your dex, and you should get your max damage out of that. You'd be fine. Because, like, no point of putting an infusion on. If, you know, they're high level, it doesn't matter. And there's no problem with being SL 200 and 250. None. No problem. It's just, you know, a lot of regions, they have, like, their own little metas. I remember, let's say, what's the Japanese meta again for Dark Souls 2? I think it's 200. The YouTube live setup is disgusting. Really? How is it so disgusting? Is it just, like, weird? Royal Uzi Durk is my favorite rapper. Oh, man. Yeah. That. Now, try saying that 3 times fast. Like, just try saying it 3 times fast. The Japanese meta is 802. Okay. That was a good one. That was a good one. That's funny. Did you know there's a Brazilian and I think there's like a Spanish meta? Like, I think it was around like 250. Around that. It's not like Twitch. Yeah. YouTube Live is weird. I watched a couple of YouTube Live streams, but that was mostly me watching Japanese fuckers run around and backstab each other on Dark Souls Remastered. So that was fun to watch as they pummel each other with giant great clubs full of crystal, destroying each other in two hits. 802 with hyper armor and healing in arena. Now, let me tell you what the max level of Dark Souls 2 is. It is 838, and that sounds exactly like it. I've came across my fairy 838s too, so that's fun. Back to work. Love your YouTube channel. Keep up the good work. Thumbs up. All right, Don. Love you too, man. Dom is probably one of my favorite Twitch viewers. Only one that's ever donated to me. That's why. He took the initiative, and I appreciate that. What else? I ban him. That sounds like a very fine quote to me. Look, I hear that Yukis is making strides to become a better person. Let's support that. You know. Ah, rip. Rip. So today, I'm just going to ask you guys, what should I do today? Because I jump into it myself. I don't have a credit card. I can't donate. It's fine. You're good. I never tell anyone to donate to me. You don't have to do none of that. Dirk, how do you feel about half your channel being from Yukis? Isn't that weird? I feel it weird. I made that video like way back. Like this is like 2 months ago. And it blew up recently because the YouTube algorithm is fucking weird. The YouTube algorithm pushes things from way back. Like, you need to, like, put out a video from, say, like, 1 month ago to really for it to get its max potential in views, which is very weird. So when people were hitting me up about the Yuka stuff, this was, like, 2 months old. This was, like, 2 months old or something. I actually found this video because of that video. A lot of people did. This is how it is. You know, they find me. It wasn't from Yukis, huh? Some of my people are day oneers. Like, I've been around. Some people... Let me tell you where I'm from. I'm from the Xbox community when I first started off on Xbox. Dark Souls 2. 2015. Very early 2015. And then late 2015, I was streaming. And that's when people in the community started noticing me. They most of them made fun of me because around that time in 2015, I was 150, but like I was on Xbox. And when you're on the Xbox community, a lot of the PS4 community and PC community would look at you and say, "Ew, Xbox? Ew, who are you?" I always stream snipe Yukis and beat the fuck out of him. Rages so hard, it's funny as fuck, and he hates me. That's funny. Like, the best way Yukis could, like, beat stream snipers is to not ignore, not to put hate on them, adapt. So, like, I would say find the... How many hours do you have PC plus Xbox? Oh, okay. Damn, that's... You know what's crazy? I have my Xbox right over there, too. Next to my PS4. And I remember I put one of my characters, it's a 150 character, put 99 hours into this. And you know, the only reason why I put 99 hours into it is just pure PvP. Beat the game like so many times, and that's just pure PvP. 999 hours was on one of my characters, I think, and then the rest of them I think is around like 500 200. And then on PC, I cannot honestly tell you because I've been soft banned 8 times, if you want me to be correct about that. 8 times, basically the max your family share can go. had to rebuy the game because I got soft banned 8 times. So I can't tell my hours at all. It's really weird. I have about 200 hours in PvP in this game. See, that's a fair and decent amount right there. And at that point, I would say that that is... Yeah. It, holy shit. Like, you know, people don't realize that, like, I subconsciously had this tunnel vision for this game, and it's so weird. BRB, I'm at my grandma's, and she lives in a farm, so you already know that ain't gonna happen. You know, from there, I'm thinking the connection, you probably won't be able to see the stream because of the farm, but, you know, you sound like you gotta get to work. If you're gonna get to work, all right, you're gonna get your workout in. You have a great day, and I hope you enjoy. I hope the VOD finds you well. It's not that much. I would say 200 hours is good. Because the refund for this game is about... What is it? How many hours do you have to have a refund for Dark Souls 2? For PC? I think it's like... 2? 1? 1 hour? All that matters is you're not getting a refund. You ain't getting no refund. Miyazaki don't want that. It's not that much. 500. I don't know. That's funny. So, now think. If you think about all the hours you put into Miyazaki's game, have to go, man. See you in the 1 hour if you're still streaming. I have 1,000 hours between all Souls games. Sound like a dedicated man, and I salute you. All right? I salute you. All right, man. Dario, I'll see you around if I'm back in an hour. I should be streaming only for 2 hours. I don't want to do too much. I have, like, some work to do. I'm dying. It's, like, 38 degrees. Why is it 38 degrees? When will you reach the legendary 7%? I don't think today I'll reach 7%. I don't think I will. Yesterday, at 5%, I was getting... Woo, I came back, and people were like, ah, Dirk's coming back. Let me show him what I learned. Let me show him some things. I'm like, ah, fuck. Do you sit on the toilet to take a piss? No. I think that's too much energy. Because you have to get up. You have to get down and then get back up. That's too much, man. That's so much energy, man. I'd rather just piss by you know, putting up the seat. I have faith you'll hit 7% and a higher in due time. Hopefully. Maybe even 9. Oh, man, dude. Wow. 9%? Hold up. You better stop that. You better stop that. 9% doesn't sound... Sounds a little crazy. Sounds like we're on some... Woo, let's calm down. Stay at 6%, you know? It's pretty fucking spicy. Yo, 10% makes the panties drop. You hear that? You guys hear that? I made myself an alarm for when I know I'm babbling and I talk too much. So I can stay on track. So today, I want to focus on viewer weapons. So viewers choose my weapons. I don't care. Just throw out a weapon. I'll use it. Depending on the opponent's skill, if I can use the weapon against the opponent or not, I may switch. Like, say if it's an 838. Then I'm dipping out with that black crystal. Because I can't do mini boss fights. That will take up my whole stream. I don't have much time. But. If so. We got to start off with. This. So. I want to focus on. Bettering. Myself with. I would say straight swords. Also, if God show up, with now his numerous alts similar to my name, please ban them. Then spit in his eyes. I wouldn't do that. If anything, Gods would reveal himself to me, because I think I've known him for the longest, and he's more of like, I think he's a better person than anything. There was times that anyone goes through like some weird parts of their life, you know, stressing over stuff, but I think Gods is a good person at heart, and if anything, he just wants to play with me. If he does want to play with me, he would stream snipe me, and you know, it would be whatever. Either he does it with an ult or not, it doesn't matter. Still a good friend, and I honestly would say that I think he was one of the leading factors of where I am. I want to do straight sword, I can go curve. I might go curve with a sickle and see how it feels. I need to focus on... Hold on, let me... Right here. There we go. I need to focus on... Not getting hit is always the first key. And good spacing. You're surprised that DS2 PvP is still alive? Oh, very much. It's been alive. From the jump, I would say it's been alive. It's just what you see. I would say the most, like, constantly what you'll always get is a match will be from PC. And then PS4, you'll get, like, maybe half of what PC would probably get. On Xbox, you might get like probably a little bit less. 9%. Why is everybody... You know, I had someone say 9%, like just a couple of seconds I parry you. Almost. I just had that too. DS3 PvP is kind of dead. A lot of the community is kind of dying, I've noticed. A lot of it is. But, you know, everybody's going to have the respected communities, I would say. But you say DS3's kind of dead? Man, you're crazy. Mila Jolovic. Hey, Dark Crimson, how you doing today? Good morning. Well, it used to be morning. Hope you're having a wonderful day. We're both wearing the same thing. Now, little note out there for people that fight katanas. If you strafe right, you'll see me strafe right a lot. It's only because if they do their running R1, it shouldn't hit you. He's not really doing R1s. He's very passive. Thank you. There we go. I've heard of you somewhere before. Cheers. Yeah, yourself? Well, I'm doing fine. I had my morning coffee, and I get to stare at its lovely message at the bottom. It says hashtag truth. I don't know. I guess that means I'm woke or something. Sounds like a good coffee mug. I've heard of you somewhere before. Maybe from one of the streams he sniped before. Weird. Prefer pancaking people with a giant club myself. Cheers, five. Ooh, hey. Cheer. No, it's like real life. Heard you. You know what's crazy? You, me and you probably met. What if that's possible? What if it's possible? It's pretty hard to miss me if you see me. Where are you from? That it's morning. It's Ireland, it's five. Oh, you're in Ireland right now? So, from America, as you can tell, it's 12 right now for me. Are you a big black guy? Okay, here we go. So, people generally think that I'm big. They think I'm big. I don't think I'm big because I look at myself every day. But I wouldn't say that. My height is like 6. Like, I'm 6 foot in shoes. But when it comes to me, like, taking off them shoes, you're going to find a 5'11 man. 5'11. So that's why you'll see me always in shoes. Like, I used to play football, too. So I would always lie in my football stats. You can actually lie in it, too. It's really, really weird about the industry. You can say that you're 6 foot only because you wear the cleats. You know what I mean? How much do I weigh now? I think would be like somewhere around 195. I slimmed down a bit, trying to cut up, not bulk up anymore, because that's what I'm used to, is bulking up. Cutting up is way different. But if you met me, someone has me blocked in arena already? How's that even possible? You shouldn't be able to. You shouldn't be able to get blocked already. No, I'm in chat. I don't get why he healed. Why would someone block you in chat? Maybe you know something that... That's weird. Maybe you know something from someone here that they don't want you to know. Some conspiracy, you know, some conspiracy stuff. A little weird. Is the music... Not music, I mean, is the sound okay? Let me check for a second. Yeah, there it is. Make it sound better. That fake backstab, though. Nah, it's not fake. I'll tell you why it's not fake. So, everyone thinks that those are face stabs and fake backstabs. Those are actually due to, like player latency on my screen, though. It may not look it, but on his screen, he got it, so that's how connection works. What I should have done, and what everyone should know, I repeat this a lot, is to not roll back. Never roll towards the person that's backstabbing you, because that's how the priority ranges for backstabs are. You need to roll away from them. So that's a common mistake I do sometimes, but understanding it is the best thing. So if someone is in the animation of a backstab, do not roll behind them, do not roll towards them, roll away from them. It's just a circle. You know what I'm saying? It's just a circle. Why does everybody like jesters? It's weird. Warp. No backseating. No backstabbing. Yeah. This guy is very passive. I don't think he wants me to do too much. What the hell? Very passive. There we go. Oh, that's crazy. GG. What I should have done is, like, maybe I could have stance swapped to the offhand. Unlucky. Unfortunate. Yeah. What time is it? 12:13. Good. Now, at least it wasn't like DSR backstabs. It's in and out. It's in and out. Yeah, someone blocked me and has me blocked. You're talking to invisible people. I'm talking to people on Twitch too, so I don't know. Does poise work in Dark Souls 2? Oh, absolutely. There's a lot of it. Poise works phenomenally. Like, it's either or type stuff. Nice parry. He backstepped. That should hurt me. Should have had the lost sinners. Ooh, would have been nice. That would have been just nice. That's weird. Now, priority over backstabs, you gotta understand. With the roll, how much roll do I have right now? I'm just chilling, waiting for my mates to stream, to start streaming for 2 hours, and I introduced him to DS, and he just finished one, and he's at the beginning of two now. Yeah, I was thinking about poise, meanwhile, you were fighting that Havel helmet dude with the leggings. Yeah, so he wears that just so he can have the poise. Maybe he can beat out, say, a roll, maybe like a running Ice Rapier R1. That's why they do that. It's a hide night, dude. One of the finer people in life. Yeah, just like that. Yeah, it's how it is. See, like, I can see how people can backstab me because I have no role. Another life. So it's kind of, yeah, I can see where the backstab gets priority because my roll is pretty bad. Do you see that roll? Old jab. Well, I didn't have anything else on my offhand. And there's no point in swinging a big old Marikuma just to hit somebody one shot. It makes a big difference when you use these small blurs. So, I would just take, you know, the time to actually use them. That's the power of poise. So if you wanted to know if poise works, there's your answer. The power of poise. That's a lot of poise, though. Ow. So. Oh! Hello. Thank you. I appreciate that. He's back. He's back. That would have been a good one, too. In Dark Souls 2, are backstabs broken like in Dark Souls 1? Now, hold up. Yes, they can be. They can very much be. Backstabs are broken in that game as well, but like you don't see many people using the backstab mechanic. Say if, I don't know. Hold on, let me fight this guy with, say, a halberd. When you know you gotta take this bad boy off. What was that noise? Oh, no, it was just that. Oh, it's Vampire. What's up, Vampire? How you been, big dog? Gotta love backstabs. Yeah. Well, I had to take off like a couple of pieces of armor so I can avoid backstabs. Now, I think I might need a... Yeah, there we go. GG. What was I saying? Something about vampire. I was saying hi to vampire. Yo, vampire, what's up? Haven't seen you in a minute, man. You stayed up all night? Really? Is it true that Dark Souls 2 PB is just consistent on running attacks? Okay. So, that right there, I'll explain. First playing Skyrim and I stole mad shit. That sounds funny. That game's comedy. Skyrim's funny. To be honest, I started playing Skyrim back when Dark Souls was getting popular. And I was choosing from either or, and you can tell which one led to another. Is it true that Dark Souls 2 PvP consists of running attacks? Okay, so that's a good question. Because a lot of people play different ways. So, like, if you're playing with a weapon that can't be used for running attacks, you obviously can't. You know what I mean? Ooh, that should have done it. Now this can come down right to it. Oh man. Let's see where this goes. Ah. Okay. Dang, it's hard for me to ask questions when I'm fighting. It's weird. I made it as soullessly as I could and expected no lock-on mod for PS4. Okay. I was asking because community comments says that a lot. So, what I think is going on is that people get confused that this is what you might see in PvP. In DS2 PvP, you might see that. Third person all the way. That's actually fun, actually. If you do third person, that's way fun. So, most people will play like that, or they'll play... Because that's, like, very aggressive playstyle. Not a lot of people can handle it, but at the same time, if you're passive... probably could beat that. You're gonna see a lot of curved sword users do this because what they want to do is prey on your roll catches, so when you run away they're just that, because they most of the time they think that you're gonna run away. If you don't run away and you hold your ground, that's when you stop the aggressive attacks. So having a good understanding of neutral playstyle, of being able to stand there and hold your ground from a guy that's coming at you real fast by attacking him, that'll make that guy run away. That'll make the guy who's being aggressive as hell, him being aggressive, he'll start being more lenient with being aggressive because he knows he'll get countered. It's just how it is. Now, with a passive playstyle, you're waiting till your man hits you almost every single time. Neutral, you're just holding your ground. So, to sum it all up, three different playstyles: neutral, passive, and aggressive. Oh, almost had him. Oh, I'm bleeding. I'm bleeding. Oh. No. This is why I'm only at 6%. So, your question was, why is my stream 6%? I'll answer it after this fight. Give me a second. You guys are very patient today. I'm really loving this chat. Very patient chat. That's weird. Let's do that again. Hold up. No one expects the offhand katana, huh? So it's 6%. Hold up. OD Empa. If I'm saying that right, OD Empa. Odd Empa. What's up, man? How you doing, man? Hope you're having a great day. Thanks for stopping by my stream. Sorry. I'm having a great day so far. Odd Empa. Ah, okay. Thank you. I remember that. Hope you're having a great day, though. We was kings! 7% off. Greg. Hey, Greg, how you doing? Epic sale. Slaps the hood of the car. See this bad boy? This thing can R1 at speeds that you can't see. Slaps the hood of your katana. That's funny, man. But, it's 6%. Max. You know what I find fun about some stance swapping? You can really create the most weirdest combos for no reason. Like, they're probably not in any way, shape, or form effective. Is that Climax? R2, R1, and two R1s, and then You mean that? Two-handed R1 into one-handed R2? Is that what you're trying to say? Oh, that crack, yo. I still haven't learned how to do that. I don't know how to. Maybe. Like that? Probably has zero effective. Your stream vids are satisfying to watch. Oh, thank you so much. I hope my gameplay is that good to watch. So, what I want to do is finally make this video series. It'll be fun. Make that video series for tech. One-handing to two-handing is so, like, a little different for me. Lost your sanity? Humanity? Oh, I thought it was sanity. If it was that, then that would mean the Pale Man was in my chat. And who would think the Pale Man would show up? There. Oh, you tried it. Don't even need a ring swap. Can't see other comments in chat? Yeah, I can. I can see them all. I can see both Twitch and YouTube chat. It's just like sometimes it moves a little fast. So if I miss your question, just repeat it and I'll answer it. Because there's not many of you guys anyway, so it's not that bad. Oh, because it's on Twitch and YouTube, Vampire. So, like, you're making comments on Twitch, right? There's people making comments on YouTube as well. Also, lost your humanity. I hope you're having a great day, man. I only see mine. Now, that's a new one. Should be able to see everyone else's, so. He only has two swings. The one thing I like about the Dark Drift is that the rolling R1, no matter what, if you connect once, it will connect the whole combo, no matter what. That's if you have stamina for it. Wait, you know what's crazy I had? And I didn't even notice? I just noticed something. I had the spider fang just sitting there. That's how much you know I don't care. Okay, let's see. I assume you like DS2 the most. So, I would say that PvE-wise, I liked DS1 because it got me into the series. And then when I played PvP there, it was fun, which led to Dark Souls 2. And then I started loving DS2 PvP the most because it had its the most variety for me. It has just... Literally, you can use any weapon and find it good. Just good. Any weapon, and you could somehow make a win out of it. Somehow, in any situation. That's why I like DS2 the most, because it's like the home for me. If you beat all the Dark Souls games, what do you do after? You play PvP. It's a normal. Yeah, thanks. Same to you. This is actually my first time watching your stream. Well, I've been streaming since 2015, really. Most of the times I'm music streaming. I'm either chilling out, listening to music with other people, and talking, having features, you know, regular stuff. So what I'm trying to do is... Okay, you were saying? Oh, DS2 PvP is objectively the best. So, I would so say it's... yeah. For me, yeah. But everyone has their own opinions. It doesn't matter. I mean... I love PvP in almost every one of the Dark Souls games because I've played every one of the Dark Souls games, if that makes sense. Most people objectively like to say that another PvP from a different community is bad because they never played it. But I think all of them are okay. It's okay. But I just find two to be the best. Nah, you have the nubs that can't play PvP. Really? What do you mean by nubs? Noobs? I always do that. I guess my ring sweat up isn't the same as it used to be. I'm used to my Hornet Ring being the first thing out of my... Is my roll too fast? Nah, it can't be. So I should be reaching that far. Panic roll. Panic roll. Panic roll. Panic roll. What was I saying? DS1, DS3, DS2, but they all have their benefits and flaws. Is that your order of what you like? In PvE or PvP-wise is a better question. Yep, in PvP. Wow! That's crazy, man. So basically, you're saying you dislike DS2 PvP? Nah, I'm playing. I would say, in the normal standpoint, a lot of, like, most people would agree with your opinion. Most people would agree with it. I would say, probably up there around 60 to 70% of the Dark Souls community believes it. Sir didn't notice it put nubs. I've played DS2 PvP for a while now. When I got DS3, I found out DS2 PvP was extremely cancerous and repetitive somehow. I would say that's the general thing that people want to say about DS2 PvP. Oh, I'm sorry. My bad. I didn't know you were going to come and bow to me. I'm sorry. My bad. My bad. I apologize. Like, I'm not used to that. People run up to me. I got PTSD. You understand? Playing DS2PvP, it messes with you. Let's go. So, like, DS2 PTSD is just me just... Huh? Nani? Okay. Maybe this isn't that bad. I don't know. You never know if a connection is as bad as you think it is. I am queuing up weird-ass attacks. I don't know. He's just queuing them up. The one thing about fighting laggy people is, like, half of the time I'm trying to understand, are they lagging or are they not? It's weird. Like, you know when someone goes immediately just stand still for no reason and they kind of, like, look like they're lagging and they're not? I'm trying to figure that out with that guy. I was like, is he lagging or am I just, huh? Weird. DS2 Warp Sword Katanas and Dark Magic. Nah, I'm not the... Nah, DS2 is the best for me. Yeah, DS2... Yeah, I love it the most, I would say. Yeah, especially Arena. Honestly, it's garbage, but DS2 1v1 is fun. I only have 60 hours in 2. All Dark Souls games have its cancer, though, to be fair. Okay. Dark Souls 1 Backstab for beginners and Dark Magic. At least in my perspective, every single PvP encounter I'd have with an Ice Rapier, Havel, Spellcaster, 99 Vigor, Phantom. That's very true. Okay, I'm not going to knock you for that because the community is kind of fucked with that because these are the same people that were mad that they were SL 150 at one point and got completely toasted on by either good players or either the same cancerous players that they became to be. It's weird. The DS2 community wasn't really trying to figure that out. The majority of them are either bridge monsters, Havel, and they just sit here. Oh. He came running at me with a R1, huh? Is he okay? I think his controller died. I think you need to charge your controller. Crazy. GG, Ben Garl. Ah, I forgot. I need this BC on, like, bridge. Like, the only complaint I have about, like, the DS2 arena is just bridge. It's, like, the most unfun thing to do because you can't really move around or do anything or you fall off. Most times, I fall off a bridge. DS2 warp swords. Okay. No, curved swords. OP. Shields and straight swords. No poise. Mm-hmm. That's true. Everyone has their own. Every Dark Souls game has its own thing people do. And it's just the meta they love to just go straight to most commonly. So you got your DS3 curved swords and OP shields with straight swords. You know, it's regular. DS2 has warp swords, katana, spears, you know, lances. Regular stuff. Aside from that, every DS PvP is unique, and I find it really entertaining. There goes one right there! There goes... just as he says it. Bro, you know that if I looked it up on my honor meter, he was probably 200, around that. I just don't feel like having boss fights. But it's fine. Is that warp offhand? All right, let's go. It's a Japanese player, right? Yeah, that's a Japanese player, all right. You know, I was thinking to myself, like, huh. Maybe this is just a guy that isn't a Japanese player. And just pretending to be a weeb or something. That is a full-fledged Japanese player. And he's wearing no poise. But he's using the warp sword just right, using neutral. Let's see if I can bait him in. Why would he do that? I don't get that. There's no reason to do that. Don't throw firebombs in PvP for DS2. It doesn't make sense. No one gets hit by it. Huh? Nani? But Nani? I gotta battle early hits too. What the fuck? Wait, what? You know? This is what I get for idolizing Japanese players. That's funny. GG. That was a real Nani moment. That was a real Nani moment. I hope I get him again. That's funny. I was trying to test out if, like, he knows how to use warp swords, and he started coming at me with some aggressive play, right? Then he swapped to neutral, tried to go with two standing R1s, two-handed, and he was hoping so I can get caught up in the two. Only got hit with, like, the one, turn around, try to get him with a counter. We both trade, and now it just led to the one-shot battle. The one-shot battle, a little weird. I do my rolling R1 with the dagger because that's the fastest, one of the fastest attacks that can come out of this game is that and a Santir spear. Even though I technically hit him and killed him first, he still gets it because, you know, that's just how latency works in the games. The shield tech. So strong. What if I just use Berserker? Mind games, they say. No! Nani! It's mind games. Mind games, huh? GG? 6%. It's only 6%. Oh my god, I can't wait. What if I get to 9%, guys? Oh, I'm gonna be addicted to this game again. Oh no. That's how it starts. My problem with DS3 PvP is it's easy, and it's, to be honest, the skill in DS3, it really comes down to your weapon. Yeah, that's true. That makes sense. Great Lance Poise monsters are another really annoying meta in DS2. Great Lance Poise meta? Okay, so what I do with Great Lances is that, because the best way to understand Great Lances is to start using them yourself, right? So I started using them with my Axe gameplay way back. And I noticed that if they're locked on Great Lance users, they're never hitting me, if you understand spacing. If they're lock off, there might be, that's a problem. That's the real problem. Hello. Hello, great sir. Are we gonna fight up here?
Thank you.
We're gonna fight up here. This is about to be like the rolling R1s battle. Let's see what happens. I think if I... GG. That was fun. He could have really fucked me up. Don't know why he didn't. It's really weird. F for respects, my guy. F for respects. In DS2, you'll see that PvP is like, it's very nonchalant. I think it could be the most chillest experience possible. You can use any weapon and win. It don't matter. I'm gonna start using the Alone Sword too, because I think that's a little cool. And I might show you guys something cool too while I'm at it. Thank you. That was very nice of you. Great present. No, you're not supposed to just immediately parry. Dark Souls 2 isn't like that. You gotta predict the parry. I need to do the... That right there scares the shit out of people for some reason. What's that noise? What is that noise? Very passive. Oh, I forgot the Alone Sword has a dagger backstab? What? What? That's crazy. So I can just do this. Not exactly what I wanted. Well, that was my alarm. I knew it. Yo, Dirk, once I get my net back, want a duel? I play on PS4. I'll be honest, I'm shit at DS2 PvP, and I'm trying to fight people that are better than me, if you're up to it. Chillingness increased by 50%. You heard that, right? That was my alarm. Yeah, I'll fight with you. What you want to do is send me a message on PS4. Tell me who you are and everything. and I'll get to you. Especially if I start playing on PS4 like that. I'm not trying to like play for very long. I'm limiting my hours to 2. That way, like, every day as the percentage gets bigger, then I'll stream a little bit more longer. DS2 PvP plus that alarm, almost fell asleep. Yeah. Damn! The power of buffs. Everybody wondering, why are buffs so OP? Shit took half my health. And no animations. God damn! Maybe I shouldn't have ran in there with an alone sword. The weapon was not ready for that. GG's to my mans, though. That was pretty, he just stood his ground, pressed R1. Everyone says, I don't like to blame things on lag sometimes unless it's, like, really potent lag. Unless it's really potent lag, that's when I know. But since I know that he has that buff, and I actually have to defend against it, the best thing I can do is keep my space. Are you still using it?
Hello.
Oh, you're going mid tier now? What happened to you using top tier? Get that. Let me see if I can mess up his head a little bit. Oh. So close. Let's see if he'll fall for it. I think you could backstab that and then backstep that and then do something about it. But you know, that's just how it is. Oh, I'm also RCing and QAing poo. Dang! Let me tell you about RCing. It's not the best thing to do, but only if you know, like, someone's like over leveled. Then, yeah, I do it too. The thing I hate the most is the DS2, how the repost animation works. So, yeah, it's kind of OP, I'm not gonna lie, because you can't really get out of it. And most of the times you're trying to get out of it, you gotta know how to quick roll out of those situations. But, yeah, it's pretty, yeah, you can probably walk your dog, take a shit, and brush your teeth, and you can come back and repost somebody off of a parry, yeah. It's very possible. I ain't gonna knock that. Like, I went for a 2-mile run, came back, and I reposted somebody. Just. Oh my god, katana runnings. Katana running R1s are pretty bad. this dude is really weird. He fights weird. Like, he doesn't know what he wants exactly. I want to figure it out just in a couple of seconds. RC? Nah, can't be. The one thing I like about Spear is that you can play it on Locked On. Why are you using a washing pole? Like, you just destroyed everything you had going for yourself. Why a washing pole? There's no point in any time where you need a washing pole. Honestly. I mean, you could fight with it and probably win, but why a washing pole? This isn't DS3. I'm playing. This backpedaling is so crazy right now that I might just do this instead. Come on. You can come here. I don't budge. Come here. You know what's crazy? Is that his animations are coming out very fast. What the fuck? Is that me? Most of this is just a big, fast waiting game because he won't do the overarching R1. This dude's about to get face stabbed if he keeps backpedaling. What? Yo, that's what I'm saying. I knew it. I'm not crazy. Animations are coming out pretty fast, but that's a unique trait to have, I guess. See that? Like, the rolling attack is just coming out. Like that! Like, holy shit. The minus roll 2.0? Skipping the roll is straight into the R1? Like, right there, right there! I'm not crazy, right? Is that regular? That's crazy. It's like a boss battle. I don't know why it takes him. It takes 20 hits to kill this guy. It's a high possibility that he might be overleveled. Maybe. Why does it come out so fast? That is insane. Where do you get that power? Where can we trade connections? It's just rolling, rolling. I don't understand it. That's so weird. That's so funny. You think it'd come in? Yo. Latency's fucked. I can't parry latency like that. It'll just leave for a disappointing outcome. Oh. Nope. Nothing. He doesn't do running attacks, too, so it's just very. Okay, he just does it one time. There we go. He's like, I can't get hit. Won't get hit. How long can this man last? No. What? Alright, now we're hitting a boy. Hmm? Nani? Yo, I'll be back in a sec, okay? Bet. You can take a break. How does this animation does that? I'm not crazy, right? GG, but I'm not crazy. There's no way. I know, but it's fun to do katana running, and you can get so much hate mail off of it. Yeah, I main and Black Steel and S-Doc, or either Rapier. Read the Bible, take a shower, get a girlfriend, beat DS1, take another shower, change your whole equipment, and take the repost. Yeah, that's crazy. I'm pretty sure he's over 150. Was that like a mini boss or something? I'm not crazy. It might have been a high leveled. I see that, Dirk, you're having fun. Yeah, I was having fun with, like, with that guy. I mean, it was weird. It's like his rolling attack. Can I see the washing pole for a sec? Or something like that? Like, his rolling came out way faster than it should have. It was immediately. I don't know. Like, I know all the weapons. And I know for a fact a washing pole doesn't come out that fast. That's weird. So, if you haven't know, a lot of people ask me the question, why don't you parry? Why don't you parry? Why don't you parry? This and that. Well, most of the times, I try not to, because if I get in the habit to doing it, I'm going to do it on mid-tier players, top-tier players. It's a high-risk reward situation when it comes to using it in mid-tier fights and top-tier fights. So, if I get in the habit of doing that, it's just not going to be good for myself. I'm having fun. Yeah. You know, it's all fun. It's all you can have in this game. It really is. I think the most fun I have in this game is when I'm using mid-tier. I would say I'm having the most fun. A lot of people like to play top-tier weapons. I like mid-tier. I just know how to fight with top-tier, too. I like fighting with obscure weapons and making them good. Like, weapons that you've never heard about and making them really good is definitely my forte. They call this the Katana Bait Dance. Original creator is Minus. Well, there was no katana on that one. Come on, keep hitting me. Go ahead. You can keep hitting me. You can keep hitting me. I think it's the most fun I'd have playing DS2 when you made a great bow rapier build. Oh, man. I remember that. There used to be a guy that used to go around and just have, like, the... I forget what weapon it was. It was the... Some halbert. It was the Raph halbert or something like that. I forget what it was called. And he would spam the R2 where the AoE would hit the top of the arena. We're talking about the mid-statue arena. Where you hit the top, and the AoE would blast everyone from up top. So I'm standing up there, and I knock him off, get him down to half health. You know what he does? He hits that R2. I'm thinking, like, what is he doing down there? Oh, I'm hearing some noise. Boom! Big explosion underneath me. I get hit with the AoE right underneath me. I kind of fling back. I'm like, what the fuck? That's half my health right there. This guy had a weird build. He would use like the he would use that halberd and he would buff it with dark infusion. People have like this weird, like, you'll meet people in DS2 Arena that have like their own personality, their own build, and they stay faithful to it. Some people you can find that in cosplay for days. Yeah. But who does he look like? Is a better question. It's Guts! Hi-yah! It's fucking Vengaro Gutsbill, bro. Show me what you got. This man's looking for Griffith. Yoink. He got me with the backstab. That was actually really good what he did there. Now let's see if Guts got what it takes. Look at him. Oh! He queued up a running attack. And then... Yeah! That's literally me. That's pretty good. That's funny. You know what he knows too? It is a cosplay. Because... only good players know that you can cancel the running R1s and then just go straight into a rolling R1. That's pretty good. GG's that, man. Guts would have literally stance swapped or do more jumping attacks, though. One thing you find in DS2... you find that everyone is it just has fashion. Everyone has fashion. There's like some type of fashion going on. It's not the same thing. See what I'm talking about? It's freaking the Alone Knight. Getting beat up by a samurai. There we go. I'm backstepping too early. Backstepping way too early. Squid has that sexy bounce. Alright, I'm back. Granny! Granny soup ladle, more like granny poop ladle. Dark Souls 2, more like too many weeboos. Oh, fucking... Squid is the sexiest. Why is Squid, like... you're gonna see some, like, really weird fashion. I've never got why Squid was the most picked thing. It's just... ugh. It's a squid. Alophis wore it. Minus wore it. Squid hats. Bro, I think my fashion's alright. You know what I did? I backstabbed him. I backstabbed him, and then I stance swapped while I was backstabbing to see if I could fuck up the animation. It was really weird. I was trying to really fuck up the backstab animation. I'm just trying anything to break this game again. I saw someone do, I think it was Granny, who was doing QAs while rolling, and honestly, that shit blew my mind. Do you realize how fucking good that is? If you can quick attack someone, while rolling, coming out of a roll, rolling R1, that's fucking serious. Say like a longsword. I'll try that now. Like, people be quick attacking. Do I still remember how to? I think I do. I don't think I remember. Let me see if I do. Oh, I do. I still do, but no, we're not like Ouroboro, come on. Back step, then parry, normal stuff. Now let's see if I can QA this one more time. See, that's how you QA. I have no good spacing with the QAs, though. I need to practice it. Might as well practice on him, though. Hold on. Nope. I haven't done QAs in a minute, man. How was it again? Damn. I'm really forgetting my QAs. That's insane. You think you could do that at parries? Yeah, yeah. Oh, my God. Bro, you can... How am I forgetting this? Hold up. It's B and Y together, right? Hold up. Oh, I think I know why. I'm on an Xbox controller. And as far as that goes, I'm not used to that. There it goes. That's how you break Dark Souls 2. I'm back on point again. Like, seriously? There's people out here that consistently do this. You just go around just showing everyone how's your day. Oh, you love your videos when you're messing with Yukis. Oh, thank you, man. Omega Spartan 316. Thank you for showing up with stream. How does that work? I'm afraid if I teach people. Look, everyone in this game knows how to do it at this point, I think. Nah, I'm playing. Yeah, I ban him. I don't like magic. Oh my God. That man hit me with the yoink. No stamina. Can't do any rolling R1s. You know what? Power stancing has to be still my favorite thing in this game. Honestly. Like, consistently. I honestly have to say that it still is. So do you think, who do you think's worse at video games, Yukis or Darkside Phil? Alright, Darkside Phil, hands down. I don't even need to think about that. I don't even need to think about that at all. Darkside Phil has to be the worst, one of the worst. I would say here it goes down like, no, you know what? No, I think someone took that. Someone just took that title of who's the worst Dark Souls player. Compared to Mike? Okay. That's... Is Aaron Hansen. Hold up, hold up. Sorry about that. Let me where's it at again? How about this? That better for you guys? It shouldn't be that loud, honestly. But Aaron Hansen, or Game Grumps, Aaron, Ego Raptor, has to be one of the worst Dark Souls players. And Darkside Phil comes as a second for me. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I have all respect for Aaron Hansen. I like him. He's cool and all. Ego Raptor. I mean, but when he plays Dark Souls, have you guys actually sit there and watch Game Grumps of him playing Dark Souls, any of the Dark Souls, and just think, wow, this man does not know what he's talking about. And it's like he doesn't care. He sucks at video. Bruh, no, he doesn't suck at Mega Man. He's good at Mega Man. Oh my Jesus. So much health gone. He's good at some games. He's good at A Link to the Past. That shit was 20 years ago. Yo, this chat is reckless. I love it. Yeah, that was 20 years ago, Dirk. I'm gonna need you to correct that. That man is no longer good at video games. He's good at Wii Sports, Mario Party. look, Ego Raptor's cool. Like, he used to be really funny for me. I remember back in 2012, he was pretty cool. I remember when he went on that show, what was it? The PS4 show? And, like, they voted him off. And then they got him back on they got him on back on because it was popular demand to get him to return. And then he gets voted back off or something. That is so funny. Like, Ego Raptor's my man. Yo, he's giving me the works. It's Thanos! It's the man with the golden glove! It's the man with the golden glove! The man with the golden glove. What a scary dude. Like, honestly, I gave this hypothetical every single time I think about Thanos, because there's other people who have, like, better hands. And when I'm talking about hands, I'm talking about boxing. I'm talking about, like, really fighting. Like, Mike Tyson. Here's my theory, chat. Here's my little question for y'all, actually. So if you were in a cell with Mike Tyson and you were locked up with him for 24 hours, just 24 hours, and he comes at you, you wake up, you're like, huh? You look at him, Mike Tyson's just looking at you, smiling. You're looking at him, you're like, hey Mike, how you doing? He's like, I'm gonna give you two options. One, you let me punch you really, really, really hard in the face. Or two, I'm going to bend you over right now, and I'm going to make you my bitch. What would you do, chat? Now, I'll throw something on top of this. Would you get hit by Mike Tyson, like 100% prime Mike Tyson in the face, or would you rather get butt raped? It's a theoretical little thing here, because at the end of the day, you got to think about the mentality Mike Tyson has there. If you let him punch you, he might take you. What the fuck? What the fuck if they're gay? Well, if you're gay, then you might just win in all situations. I think you win, but you still get punched. So that's not really a win by Mike Tyson. If you're gay, you get butt raped, and I don't know what's gonna happen after the butt raping. Either you're satisfied having a cigarette You're just thinking, thanks, Mike. But if you're not gay, I think you're kind of in for the worst time. Hold up, let me use like a sickle or something. What? Huh? What? Huh? Why do people do this? It's not gay if he has sex. Hold up, what? I'm confused. What you said was, it's not gay if he has socks. It's not, you didn't even finish that too. It says, it's not gay if he has socks. There's no on or nothing. He doesn't have socks on or nothing. It's just he has socks. So if he had socks in his pocket, it's okay. If he just had socks, like, in any time of the day, it's just okay. You know what? That's just some seriously gay shit. That's so funny, man. Hey, don't call me. Just imagine the Hodge twins tag teaming you. Oh, jeez. That's horrible. Just going in. What if I had, like, I missed that Pate spear. Sorry about that. Going in balls. That sounds very appropriate, though. Like, what? You think I was gonna run up in there? You must be mistaken, good friend. I don't live that life. I wasn't trying to get zapped. No, you crazy. Just because you have socks doesn't mean it's okay. You're insane. It is not okay. Now this is top tier PvP. Is it really? I'm using a sickle and a Pate spear. Can somebody come and tell me? I'm about to start using a sickle and a hammer. Get my Russian viewers up. Busting all kinds of nuts. Yo, this guy's funny. Busted all kinds of nuts. Not a half a nut, a whole nut. That's so gay. That is incredibly gay. Soviet anthem starts playing in softly the back room. So, if you go back to my YouTube channel and you look at my old videos, I did a video on that. That is the funniest. It was a guy named Soviet Lover, and I said, it was so coincidental. Sorry, English is not my first language. It was so coincidental that, like, it blew my mind. I was just playing with a sickle and hammer, and he came out of nowhere, a guy named Soviet Lover, and I'm like, what the? Huh? Communist Lover? Huh? Stop following me! What? Little black bastards. We're not racist. Oh, fucking bastards. Hit the ground. Stop! Stop it! Damn hexers. How is he still hitting me, though? Wait, what? You can't... What? How'd you roll out of that? Huh? Nani? I see you're in the fine arts of dark magic. The fuck? my first language is Latin. Nah, I'm fucking with you. You guys gotta guess what my first language is, cause I don't speak it no more. I refuse to. Is it Canada? Is it Canada? What? Hey, Dario. Hey, Dario. Is it Canada? Is it Canada? Nope, nope, nope. Close. 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 He almost had it. He almost got me. I refuse to speak it. Canuck? Who speaks Canuck? Canadianese? Stop making fun of Canada. My favorite Dark Souls player on this goddamn earth. And I say this now. I don't know if he's watching this. I don't know if he finds the time or day. He doesn't play Dark Souls 2 like that anymore. But he plays, and he's from Canada. So, he also put me on to Lil Peep. I'm not even going to say his name. It's fucking Thanos. He's buff as shit. Look at him. It's fucking jacked. Oh! It's the man with the golden glove. It's scary. I'm scared of the man of the golden glove. He has the infinity gauntlet, dude. What do you do? But, like, he's not cosplaying him right, because I want him to be purple. Why is he red? He has a big chin and nose. I like how you make... I like how I made you lose your mind when you bring up the dark parts of your life with a single word. Yeah. You can. There's a lot of shit. Don't tell me it's the guy with the blue pink hair. Huh? What are you talking about? Not Portuguese and not Japanese. Hexy Mimi. Is it English? Ding, ding, ding. British of some kind. It's Irish. Bum me, boys. If you didn't know, Dirk is mixed with the disgusting Irish language. Oh, Jesus! Fucking dark magic. I'm gonna have to make up for this now. Just because I don't know how to roll anymore. I'm gonna have to make up for that whole entire attack. If I delete it too, hold up. Don't run from the sickle. Don't run from the sickle. Don't run from the sickle. Gee. Mexican, then. Definitely Mexican. You're Gaelic? Gaelic? So, my grandmother was very pale white. Pale white, Irish all the way, flowing white hair and everything. And my grandfather was, like, black as shit. He was dark as fuck. This dude has katana, and he's just spamming spells. I don't know what his point was buffing the katana. He likes hexes more. Hey, I never judge anyone's playstyle, but that was weird as fuck to me. Never used it. Mind sharing. Come and steal them. Come and steal them. We all judge. Shake my head. My man's is unique. Most of the times when I deal with like pursuers and I can't dodge it, I just pull out Dark Defenders and just... And it should do like the better job of getting it. That's the one thing. He has a washing pole, that's why. Whenever you have a washing pole, like, it makes the user, like, hesitant to use for some reason because the startup is so slow. It's so very slow. You got enough time to, like... There we go. To, like, dodge it. Only person I know that can fight with a long-ass sword is Vampire. Do they meet or work? Oh, I was talking about... I get off of thought. I lose my train of thought a lot. Okay, guys? If you notice that, because I'm talking to almost every one of you guys, because that's how much I care. I actually speak to my viewers, unlike other people. What was I saying? Let me finish my last story of how my grandmother and grandfather got together. It was just a pale white woman gets with dark, very dark black man, and they create the omnipotent beings that are called what are they called again? Technically, my race. Why you don't ban your viewers? I don't. Yeah, no, I don't. What was it? Damn, you made me lose off a track again, boy. Stop making me lose. Make me forget things. High yellows. That's what they call them. High yellows. the most of the black community likes to call them light skins. But they are their own race. If you didn't know it, it's kind of weird. They're called what was it again? It was damn, Crole? No. Crayola? No. Milano. I can't believe I forgot that. Milano. That's racist! That's racist! You ever see that one gif of the black kid that's like eating a watermelon, and then after it's just the same black kid saying, "That's racist." That's so funny to me. But yeah, it's Mulan. If I'm saying that right, like, oh my god, like, I'm so offended. Look, let me tell you this, guys, right now. I'm about to end racism right now for you guys. This is how you end racism. If you guys really, really want to know how to end racism, just say this with me. I hate niggas. But I also hate crackers. I love white people, but I love black people. That's how you end it. It's a mind state. It's really a mind state. None of it is race. It's just a mind state at the end of the day. It's how people act is what people are referring to. Mulatto was an Italian racist word. No, it's not. Everyone thinks that it was a racist, like, Italian word for it. But no, it's not. Though Italians, how their race were... You know, most of them are. I think they kind of... They mixed with black people sometime. Is that right? Like, at least a port. Like, a part of it. a part of it is like raced with it. Races are goofy as fuck. It really is, because a lot of them are mixed with each other. Soon enough, that line's going to get blurred and we won't even know what the fuck we are soon enough. In the future, you guys won't see it, but our children are all going to be the same color, believe it or not. They're all going to be the same color. They're all going to have melanin, curly hair. You know what it is? What's the name for green people? I think they're the Hulk.
What's the name for green people?
I think they're the Hulk. I think that's Bruce Banner. I think... What's the Hulk's name? Is that right? Is the Hulk's name Bruce Banner? Maybe I'm a little wrong. Nah, dude. Aliens. Yeah, dude. Aliens are a weird type of people. They're just something else. Why do you throw bombs? Oh, because it's a narrow view, so that's why you do it. Wow, I'm almost dead. Will this kill him? Yeah. Aliens, dude. Aliens are the most omnipotent humans. They're real. They walk among you. What's that? Someone give me that meme where you just, that alien's at the bed, just dancing to, It Do Not Matter. Like, how is that a meme now? Isn't that weird how memes are like that? Is the fact that we have an alien dancing at the foot of someone's bed and it's considered a meme. That shit's, and it cracks me up because people genuinely think that shit's funny. I'm just sitting there like, wow. Yukus is an alien, if you know what I mean. That was a good one. Alien math. Invaded the world of Yukus. Hey, baby. Yukus is a god. How dare you talk bad of our creator, omnipotent being that is Yukus. Yukus praise. Yukus praise. Oh my god, I got hit with the fucking... I'm pretty sure Yukus invaded him. That's so funny. Oh my god. That's a fucking good one, bro. You're cracking me up. What the fuck? I look at that comment last second, and I get fucking hit with the lightning storm. I get struck by fucking God's lightning. That is so funny. What the fuck? You know what? You never know. He was born here. Stop. Come on, man. Yukus was born here. I think. You mean Sunlight Spear? Yeah, fuck that. Remember when Dirk used to be able to avoid miracles? Good times. Good times. I remember them. Everyone very Perry happy today. Oh. What's this weird sensation I'm feeling? Who wins with a sickle? I don't know. Some random dude named Dirk. Wait, what? No.
Nani! Nani!
Oh! I dodged that! Seriously, although I've seen people talk about that, not sure if it's true from what I know. He has no... Wait, what? Okay. Why do people tell me this stuff? People always tell me this information about Yukis. It's so, like, random to me. Because I get so much stuff from him. Like, people just tell me. Hold up, there's a bird outside feeding its youngings, too. Hold up. I want to get a picture of that. That's really cool. Hold up. Guys, I'm videotaping this. Where's the bird? There it is. 69696969696969. I'm scared. Huh. Oh, it was regular? Oh, you're normal. My bad. No, you were laggy anyway. Never mind. I don't know why, but my intuition's very good. I thought that was going to be some, you know. Is your DSP punching bag? Stop. Stop, man. Look, I'm going to tell you guys something that you may not know. Or maybe you do know. Because someone, I don't know why people like to tell me this stuff. But Yukis... I think Yukis is hiding a child, and I think he neglected it. He's neglecting his child. Like, he left his girlfriend for another woman, is what I heard, and she was an EU girl or something, and that's how they broke up. And he's living at his sister's house currently. That's what I heard. I'm not saying that that's, like, fact. But it makes a lot of sense because of what I see and hear in the background of his old stream. Not his old stream, all his new streams. You know what I mean? So, that's kind of weird to me. If he's, like, on top of that and not having a social security card, like, his life... Instead of worrying about Dark Souls, I think we need to, like, you know, do something a little bit better. You know? And now he's a deadbeat dad. Bruh, it came to me out of nowhere. I didn't even know that. It was... But the thing is why he left his child and his wife... was for another girl. I think he got caught cheating or something like that. But he has never mentioned it like that. Poor kid. The kid is 5, I think. I think the kid's like 5 or 2. Something like that. I mean, he sees them like, you know, how Drake sees his child. And, you know, we can't talk about, you know, the Six God like that. Pusha T, you were hiding a child. But I find that insane. That he has a whole kid. There's a Yukis. Just think about it. There's a Yukis Leeson Jr. out there. He is out there. And he's just sitting there. One day might be watching Yukis' streams. And be like, wow. Just think about that. I would hate for that to happen. I have no kids. Rightfully as so. Ooga booga. This guy is like... Mr. Clubman with the two clubs. Clubman. I am Clubman. How does one become Clubman anyway? Oh, I had a shield this whole time? Weak. You gonna fight me with fist? I think he has like a lot of like damage for the fists. That's why he's going for it. Mm-mm. Do it again. What you want to do is bait people into to trying to get the backstab, and when they do it, you turn around immediately. Like that. Okay. Poor kid. Daddy, why don't you love me? He... I'm your son, you... I'm your son, you kiss... You're a troll. Yeah, I banned him. Yo, you're reckless. Do a barrel roll. I do them all the time. That is funny. That is hilarious. Holy fuck. I almost teared up. That was pretty funny. Yo, that's funny. You know what? There is a possibility of that actually happening. Like, the most funniest things are the truths in life. And that is a high possibility of that happening. Alright, let's use... I'm bored. I want to use this. You're right. Showtel is a 10% weapon. I need to stay on... You're right, 6%. You're right. What's a 6% weapon anyway? A Swyhander? Oh, if only he came in closer for that. Come here, let me decapitate you, baby. Let me decapitate you. He won't let me decapitate him. Nani, let my back steps go out. You know, the best way to really get, like, your greatsword hits off is that. If you use, like, a dagger or anything to come in, like, say, a straight sword, immediately go for an R1, they're going to roll into you, and then you can just go for a second swing. 6% Wabby... Lagu Uchi. Or Ice Raper. That is not 6% weapon. Ask nicely. That is not a 6% weapon. I don't know. Today, I felt like... 7% when I started using the Paid Spear and Showtel. Like, I was getting very consecutive with my Lance running attacks, and that shit was amazing. Like, the only way to really get myself back into Cog, oh my god, it's Cog, day one. What's up, Cog? 616, man. Been here for a while. Oh, the Spider Fang and Pates. Ugh. I can feel myself. Ugh, I miss it. Bro, I miss Spider Fang so much, dude. Yeah, I hate dodging those things, but what you do is just strafe them or wait for the... for it to come back out. Mm-hmm. 1v1s. Damn, immediately into 1v1s. Cog. Cog has always been... Cog has always wanted to 1v1 me. like, we 1v1 like twice in the arena, I think. And when I first met him, he waves to me. He's like, hey. I'm like thinking like, yo, Cog, this is the first time we fight. I fight him immediately. I don't remember what weapon I was using. But like, I got him down to half health. Boom, he took off. I was like, huh? Zoom, he ran so... Cog is a sprinter. I was like, huh? I had to chase him down. Zoom, I was running after him. I was like, huh? I had to really, really run after him. It was crazy. But I had to tell him, was like, I'm a track runner. I pulled out my Pate spear, started running at him. He was booking it. I saw him try to take those sharp corners around the pillar, right? You know how you can get around the pillar? Like, he was trying to run around him. Best stamina management is to never, like, hold the B button all the way like this. And just, like, do short sprints. Just keep doing short sprints, and you'll move faster than the other opponent. You not play DS3? Nah. Not today. A little bit of lags. So I'm starting to understand how to really play with it again. That right there, that gameplay, that was 7%. Holy shit. I'm starting to feel it again. Starting to feel something. Yeah, I haven't played DS3 in a while. In DS3, the invaders kill me more than the enemies and bosses. I don't know how that's even possible. I thought it was like, you know, not a lot of people in DS3 anyway. But that's good that you're getting invasions. You're getting them. That's good. The player base is there. At least there's a community. Because soon enough, it's going to become a dead game. It will become it. It's crazy. We're on the bridge again. Alrighty. Nope. Yeet. Oh, hell no. Not that shit again. Yeet. You was not fucking me up with that. Now let's see if I can get him out 2v1. Hold up. Let me see if I can catch him with the yoink. Why'd you walk off? He walked off. It's impossible for me. Ah, yeah, that's crazy. I don't know why my dude walked off. He just walked off. Just like that. Crazy. Okay, guys. It's been 2 hours and 24 minutes. I think we might need to wrap it up. Because I want to get to things today. I have business today. I have a company meeting. I have one company meeting today. And I have work after that. And I also want lunch. Because it's like 2 o'clock, my lunch time is almost at 3, so I want to be able to eat and be big and strong, you know. I want to thank everyone who came out though today. It's very nice seeing you guys, man. Here's my stats, if you guys are interested. Again, thank you for coming out. I love almost all of you. You guys are definitely a breath of fresh air to wake up to. I remember most of you guys from day one, and some of the new guys I want to be more acquainted to. But thank you for coming by and watching how I play. Hopefully I've taught you some things or gave you some advice that you didn't know. Just something. Maybe some good energy so you can spread that to other people too. But I hope this reaches to you, especially out in the VOD that this is going to be. I love all of y'all. All I ask is just positivity. We're trying to like move on to a better place and a better mindset state. Cause you know, if we always focus on the bad, that shit gets to you. That shit starts causing problems. And I know people out there in my fan base that have depression and actually don't like to live anymore, but I think your life has value. I think every life has value, but most importantly yours, cause you guys gave me value. And I've always been the preacher's son. I've always been that way. But I just wanted to say that. Alrighty. I'm going to let it play out. I hope you guys had a great stream, as I know I did. It was a good morning stream. I might be able to do it tomorrow, and I might be able to do it longer, because at the end of the day, I'm just trying to de-rust. I haven't played this in like 2 months. Now this has to be like the second time I'm playing this, and I can see myself adapting again to the way people play and how the new players are playing too. All right, I'm gonna play this out. Y'all take care. Peace.
Yeah. Rest in peace to all the kids that lost their lives in the Parkland shooting. This song is dedicated to you.
Okay, she keep calling, never seen a nine. In a night on my mind, pushing the kid to ride. I'm lost to the God, I'm in my mind. Swear I wanna die, yeah, when you cross my mind. Swear I wanna die, yeah. I might start a riot, yeah. I'm so fucking tired, yeah. So what's up, what you say? Feeling good, I'm feeling great. Tired of the fucking hate. Stacking cheese all on my plate. So outside my misery, I think I'll find a way of envisioning a better
say, feeling good, I'm feeling great. Tired of the fucking hate. Stacking cheese all on my